Good morning. My name is Jonathan Hoffberger. I'm a cardiac surgeon over at Sarasota Memorial Hospital, and I'm medical director of minimally invasive cardiac surgery.
Thank you so much for joining us today, Dr. Hoffberger. What is minimally invasive cardiac surgery?
Minimally invasive cardiac surgery is open heart surgery done through a small incision. Traditionally, open heart surgery is done through an 8 to 12 inch incision in the center of the chest. What we do is we do the same operation that's performed on the inside, but we do it through a small keyhole incision on the right side of the chest, coupled with a small incision in the groin.
Who is a candidate for minimally invasive valve repair or replacement surgery?
So most people are candidates for minimally invasive valve surgery that need valve operations. So we can do aortic valve surgery, mitral valve surgery, tricuspid valve surgery through these small incisions, and then any combination of the two. In addition to that, we can do other procedures that go along with those valve operations, like ablation procedures for atrial fibrillation, repairing holes in the heart like atrial septal defects.
And what are some of the benefits to minimally invasive valve repair or replacement?
So the benefits are all the benefits that go along with a small incision. First, it's improved cosmetic results. Instead of having an 8 to 12 inch incision on your chest that everybody can see, it's done through a side incision and it's only about 3 inches in length. More important than cosmesis is that with a smaller incision goes reduction of blood loss during surgery, reduced pain, and early discharge from the hospital. Typically, patients are getting out of the hospital anywhere from 3 to 5 days after the surgery, which is similar to that of an open heart operation done through an open incision. However, their return to activities of daily life are sooner. So typically for an open heart surgery, it's about 6 to 12 weeks. With minimally invasive, we're looking at about 2 to 4 weeks for recovery.
Why don't all heart surgeons do minimally invasive surgery?
That has to do with several things. One is most heart surgeons aren't taught minimally invasive open heart surgery as a resident, so they don't get practice doing it. So when you come out of your residency and you're operating on people you depend on, and you don't have anybody that's teaching you the procedure, that becomes a pretty harrowing experience. The second reason is that it can be technically difficult, and it's a departure from what you've learned in your residency. Typically, when you do it through a big open incision in the front, you can get your hands inside and you can deal with any problems that can arise or you foresee any problems, and you can deal with them right there by getting your hands in. With minimally invasive cardiac surgery, you're working with long single-shafted instruments, and it's a little bit more difficult to control a situation should you get into one. The idea is not to get into a situation, and that requires experience. When you have a program that has low procedural volumes, the surgeons won't necessarily get that constant experience. At Sarasota Memorial Hospital, we have high procedural volumes. So I'm in doing minimally invasive cardiac surgery all the time. Naturally, with time in doing it, you get better and better at it over the years. And now we have a streamlined program that's running beautifully, and the patients are all doing very well.
That's great to hear. Why should someone consider minimally invasive surgery?
Well, number one is that your recovery time is much quicker, okay? Like I said before, instead of it being a 6 to 12 week recovery, it's really 2 to 4 weeks. Second reason is that it's safe. Our outcomes in minimally invasive cardiac surgery are the same or in many cases better than the traditional open heart operations.
If a patient has been told that his only option is open heart surgery or that surgery isn't possible, is it worth getting a second opinion?
I think it's very important to get second opinions. We get second opinions in a lot of different aspects in our life for a myriad of reasons, and open heart surgery is a very important decision that you have to make in your life. A lot of surgeons that don't do minimally invasive open heart surgery will not offer patients minimally invasive cardiac surgery. I would recommend that if you need a valve operation done, it takes no time at all to call and make an appointment and see somebody that can do minimally invasive surgery. It still may be an option for you, but then again, it might. And so for that reason, I think it's important to just ask questions and look further beyond what you're told the first time.
Thank you so much, Dr. Hoffberger. If someone is watching this video and wants more information, they can visit smhheart.com. Thank you.
Thank you.